So hello, my name is Stanislav Kinzburski. I'm working mostly, I hope you heard about OpenVZ project. How many of you heard about OpenVZ? Not many. That's nice because OpenVZ is the first container solution in Linux. So appeared in 2005 as open source solution for virtuals, which appeared in 2003. And different things which are nowadays used for any container solution, like, I don't know, PID namespace, network namespace, at least partially were put it upstream by my colleagues. So do you know when C groups appeared in the list? Which year? It was year 2006, while OpenVZ, as open source version of virtuals, appeared in 2005. So one can ask how we were actually managing resources. Because without managing resources, containers actually means nothing. And we were using bin counters, which never went upstream. It was very similar to cgroups, maybe without file system interface. It was also kernel structure, different structures, trying to account resources. Yes, and basically, 3W of cgroups. So why they appeared, what is it, in general, and where is it now? Where is it now? So they appeared as an upstream version from Google, actually, from Polminash, as a way of managing resources. By resource, basically, people understand CPU power, network throughput, memory, whatever. But basically, all of us trying to save some time and or paying less for, I don't know, for less amount of resources, having the same time but paying less. And so the appearance is an answer to this question, how we can limit resources per application, basically. So application was the goal, to limit resources for application. And it's like these bin counters I mentioned before. It's also kernel structures. It's also kernel engine allowing you to account different resources. But also it has a very nice file system interface, which allows you to easily move processes between different cgroups. And cgroups also, so cgroup is abstraction. And since you operate resources like memory, CPU, and network, and block IO, you have so-called controllers, which you can assign on a hierarchy of cgroups. Well, hierarchy is a directory, is a nested directory, and you can divide resources within this subtree. So initial interface to cgroups was the file system itself, and it's still widely used. But then Serge Hallin decided that, yeah, that we need some generic way to do things. So, and also, more or less in parallel, I don't know the exact times, systemd started to grab everything underneath of it, trying to control everything in the system. So nowadays, we have two more or less application interfaces, except, of course, the cgroups file system. One of them is CG Manager. This guy is very nice. He has his younger brother, CG Proxy, who can work in a container. And this guy sits on a dbus. And you can actually either use binary tool to send the requests on cgroups creation, moving processes between cgroups, or you can even connect via dbus, so you can write your own daemon or whatever application. And that's cool, actually, but as far as I know, as far as I've seen, at least in the source code, it doesn't allow you, it doesn't give you some kind of a feedback. So when, for example, another cgroup appeared, you actually don't have notification about it. So it's more a front end allowing you to control resources when you know how to do it and when you know which processes you have and where you want to put it. And systemd actually allows you a little bit more. So you can subscribe, you can receive notifications about new cgroups. Because actually, why you can need it? You can need it when you want to distribute resources among cgroups. You have some pool and you want to put some resources here, some there. You want to know when your cgroups appearing. But the problem with systemd is that it also provides a dbus interface, but you can only write to C groups via dbus interface. But when you want to read, you have to read it manually via file system interface. And it's not really nice, not really generic. What actually else we would like to have in OpenVZ? We would like to have this way of subscription, as I mentioned already, like systemd provides. But we also want to have unified interface to C groups. I mean, unified that we can write and read via the same interface. Not like in case of systemd, writing via dbus, serialized by systemd itself, and reading via file systems. And looks like both projects lack of it. While systemd, as I was told by Leonard, systemd don't really think that it makes sense to put this functionality. I don't have a feedback from CGI Manager yet, but maybe it will somehow merge it there. But so far, we have our own proxy dbus daemon, which basically supposed, not right now, but supposed to support the whole three, we call it backends in our case, systemd, file system, and CGI Manager, depending on what we have on the node. Oops, sorry. Why it's so less slides here? Hey, that's interesting. Sorry. Yeah. This was too fast, sorry guys. I will get back a little bit. Yeah, so it's a little bit back on the presentation flow, but so yeah, a few words about C groups. So initially, as I already mentioned, it's a way to control resources, and it has very nice file system interface and controllers allowing you to manage different types of resources. But for example, so the idea was that all of them are used in parallel and they're independent, memory controller, block IO controller. But frankly, they are intersecting, and they influence each other, for example, memory and block IO. And then initial hierarchy, initial idea of C groups of these directories allowed you to put any controllers on any subtree and mix this stuff very heavily. So as far as I know, the recent kernel was merged C groups version 2, also known like unified hierarchy. And the funniest thing with this unified hierarchy is that it doesn't allow you to create any subtrees. So you assign a controller on the root of some subtree or file system, and it actually stays here. So you kind of reassign it to another subtree. But what is more interesting in our case is that memory controller, which is one of the most important controllers, was significantly rewritten. And recently, it was given you only two handles. Place the limit of RAM which this C group can use. And there was also soft limit, which was broken. But actually, you was able only to limit the highest mark. With a new approach, with a new implementation of memory controller in this C groups version 2, you have actually three toggles. One of them is yet again limit. Another one is low, and another one is high. While low is a memory guarantee for you, for the C group. So in case of lack of memory, the C groups which are below this low guarantee will be touched or robbed for memory at the end. Yeah, that's what I told already without slide. And that's what I was talking about, that we need this unified rewrite access. Would be very nice to have it, just to simplify things. This subscription to new C groups appearing. And one more thing which probably would be nice to have is per controller access restriction. For example, when you want to control memory distribution, you probably want to be the only one guy who knows how much resources you're distributing. So you don't want to interfere with any other binary or system administrator or whatever using this interface, because you can just get in mess instead of your plans in distribution. And why we actually need all this stuff? We have an idea, and actually even an implementation, of dynamic resource distributing among containers. This is mostly related to host, but maybe also somehow be used in a container itself. The idea is that when you distribute resources initially, you are giving some amount of RAM or whatever to a container. Quite often, container doesn't use all of them, even if they are paid. And you can more or less safely get some resources back and give it to another container, or maybe you want to create one more and achieve higher density per node. And actually, one of the major questions is that you have to decide how to understand how much resources actually a container needs to be able dynamically, so you have to understand it in dynamic, to be able to dynamically adjust the usage. We use some kind of working set, so the math is not really important, but we are trying to account how much container actually uses right now after start. And we are trying to use this low guarantee, placing it a little bit higher than the current working set, which allows us to make this more or less safe for the container, unless he start to fork in a lot of new processes, make it more or less safe from the reclaimer side, so it won't be the resource won't be taken underneath of it when it works. And we would like to do it in a way of a pluggable engine, because we have different controllers. Would be nice to have this front end, which I mentioned, with a unified way to access resources, with a subscription, and with this monopoly access. And then you can plug controllers, plugins, some plugins, which controls memory or block IO or something else. And we actually, me personally, think that it can be reasonable for different solutions, because when you have these C groups, when you have resources and you can manage them, it's very nice, but quite often you don't really understand how to do it. You can put some resources here, some resources there, but then you have to remanage them manually, usually. And having some kind of pluggable engine would be very nice when you can design your own math, how you control and distribute the resources. So yeah, that's basically it. I don't know, do you have any questions or? Probably not. Okay, thank you very much.